going on, everybody?
Do something a little different today. Just got a couple more sets of foams, and I wanted to try something for a while now that I've seen on somebody else's channel. And once we get to those, it's one of those situations where if you know, you know. So we got the Gapra here. These are just Endura deep dish wheels with got the Proline crawlers, Predator compound. Both sets, the tires are identical. They got about the same amount of wear on them, and the wheels weigh about the same. So this is about as fair of a head-to-head as I can come up with. But the foam or combination of foam is what we're going to be looking at. What I've got on the Gapra right now is a set of, I don't believe that they are a like a manufactured foam. I think that it was something somebody threw together, and I picked it up over at Axial Fest. They are a single stage foam with holes drilled all the way around, and then they came with some brass rod that you could put in them to weight them down and slash tune to make it almost like a weighted dual stage system. I honestly don't know if I've actually run these since I put them in here. I can't really remember back that far. So we're gonna give those a shot first. I don't have anything extremely difficult out here in the pit currently, but I know about how this thing reacts with a normal set of tires with some dual stage foams like I normally run. So we're gonna be putting those up against what I got in the slots here. And these are, I'll put a picture of what I got going on here. This is the idea that I got from the other channel. I'm not gonna call them out, but basically I've got an Endura, like the rubber inner of their dual stage. It's the blue rubber insert piece. And then over that, I've got a hair bun. So, like I said, if you know, you know. I have always found that idea to be kind of intriguing. So we're gonna see how it does. There's definitely a lot of space, empty space, I guess we'll say. So I don't know if I got exactly the right size, but once you get into the meat of the tire, it actually feels pretty good. So we're gonna see how they stack up against each other, and I see what comes out on top. So before I get started here, if you haven't seen this rig before, it's got a Sidewinder 4 and a 9i mod outrunner. So it is extremely loud, so you may want to turn your volume down a little bit. I'll have to stop driving when I want to cut in with some commentary. So yeah, just a heads up. See what she's got. Thank you. the compression of the tire here. Pretty good compression on these ones. Phenomenal drag brake. Been up here in the pit for a while. I've been working on the creek project, so everything's a little overgrown and not well maintained up here, so we may have to deal with some extra obstacles and weeds and the whatnot. This here's my fault. I got hung up on the rear axle. Bad line choice. Since I drove this one, I forgot how touchy this thing is. It's been a while since I've driven this thing or been up here in the pit, so finding my lines again might take a second. Thank you. not sure if I got all getting all of this in frame or not. Got kind of a weird zoom going on with this camera mode. Too far. There's your Wheels Up Wednesday shot. This obstacle has never been the same since the critters dug it out. Not sure what's going on with it. This one more shot. Got that passenger front tire way up in the air. Oh, buddy. that's all she wrote for this one. Made pretty light work of that. Just in case you're wondering, I kind of had to go around the bridge. The cows are destructive. They've kind of tore things up a good bit, and I haven't been up here to fix them yet. But we'll get there. This shouldn't be difficult for either set, but I haven't been up here in a while, so we're gonna run them both up this tree anyways. one thing that this climate is good for is on this off camber transition right here that we're about to hit. If your tire, if your foams are too soft and your tires fold over, you'll slide off of this thing real quick. Especially if you go slow. No issues. As expected. Spots that I got here, and then we'll switch tires. These aren't incredibly difficult either, but if there's any issues, they'll be revealed. See how bad this driver's side front tire folds over if I can hit this corner just right. Not bad at all. Got a little bit of fold over on the inside, which is to be expected, but for a single stage foam, that's not bad at all. And then this spot here is just pure traction and a nasty transition up onto that top block. Unfortunately, this one heavily relies on my driving, just as much as the tires. So this one's not as definitive, but if it does make that transition and gets to the top, then we're in good shape. That did not sound good. I really hope I don't have another ring and pinion going bad here. Oh buddy. I'm starting to remember, I think that I was having this problem before Axial Fest, and I'm pretty sure that it's something in the transmission. The more I'm thinking about it now, you get into a heavy bind situation and the front axle and drive shaft are not spinning, and I get some nasty clicking going on, but the rear stays spinning. So I've got a transmission issue that I had completely forgot about until just now. So we will just omit this particular climb. I'm 95% sure that it would have made it, but it got bound up, and well, there's just no getting through that with the without the front tire spinning. I think that we're still in good enough shape that I'll go ahead and throw the other tires on, and we will just forego that little spot there. And so long as the transmission holds out on me, we'll get this done regardless. So we'll do some tire swapping and hit it again. Got the second set of tires on here. So these are SSD slot wheels. Still got the Proline crawlers and Predator compound. These have the blue Enjora inner rubber dual stage with I think a medium hair bun on the outside of that. So this will be the first ever hair bun test. We'll see how it goes. First outer section is super soft, but it actually does get pretty firm there in the center. These might turn out to be all right. Ooh. Binding clicking issue in the transmission is starting to get worse. I'm really hoping we can get through this. Look at that wrinkle. Since Axial Fest is over, I am going to put the Stealth X transmission back in here and get rid of this three gear.
the three gear that's in it currently is at least 7 years old. That was from an OG SCX-10, and to my knowledge, I think it's only ever been tore apart once to be re-greased, and that was it. So it's seen some wear and tear over the years. Outcome of hardline here, I'm sure it'll make it up to the top section, but as much trouble as I've been having with that upper section here lately, if these foams make that climb, I'm sold. Camera a little bit here, try to get up to the similar vantage point. There's not a whole lot of room for me to stand up here with the rig, it gets a little tight, so if I'm out of frame for a second, I'll try to get back in as quick as I can, but it's a little difficult to hold the camera and pay as much attention as I have to pay to the rig on this section here. Holy crap. Okay. So I'm at a bit of a loss for words here. I have, with the same set of tires, I had really good luck with the ProLine dual stage foams for quite a while. I have crawled this particular climb with the Ecto many a times. It was the only rig that could do this.
until I built this rig. And I had the same set of wheels, tires, and foams on this rig when I built it. And it would climb it no problem. Then the critters started digging this hole out, and I haven't made it up this thing since with anything. And as you just saw, the other set of foams with these same tires, not a chance. And it got up there a good ways, but it wasn't cutting it. In comparison, these things shot right up it with very little issue. So I'm in a spot here. The particular content creator that I have seen this particular combo on, we've had opposing viewpoints on other products, very much opposing viewpoints, and I voiced my opinion on that one a while back. It is what it is. This particular setup here, props, dude. This is an awesome combo. Never would have thought about this. I mean, I'd heard of hair buns before, but I never really felt like trying it because I liked what I was running. But the what he calls a double bun, highly suggest giving it a shot. You're looking at $18 to $20 to get the Enjora dual stages. Chuck that outer white piece and just use the inner rubber or silicone, whatever it is, and then just a hair bun, a woman's hair bun. They're like a few dollars a piece. This is awesome. I mean, I've seen them work on other rigs, but you know how that goes on the internet. You see something that looks a little gimmicky that works for somebody else, and it doesn't work for you when you take the time and effort and money to try it. This absolutely works. I'm just blown away with these things. I have no words. Other than the proof is in the pudding. You're seeing it for yourself right here along beside me. Thank you.
these might actually fold over a little less than the other foams. I am absolutely speechless. This thing is definitely a freaking animal, but these foams just made a huge difference. So give credit where credit's due. Double buns. If you know, you know. If you don't know, just search double buns on YouTube, and I'm sure that you'll find it. So give props to the dude who shared it with the world. I'm sure he's not the first person to give these a shot, but that's where I found out from. And, yeah, they're freaking awesome. So I will probably end up giving these things a shot in some of my other rigs as well. And, yeah, speechless. Only thing I can say is awesome. So hope you, enjoyed, maybe learned something, maybe think about giving these things a shot. Yeah, big thumbs up from the pit. So I hope y'all have a good one, and we'll catch you in the next one. Later.